Korea, United States,
now the second repechage,
Cuba,
Canada, Korea, United
Argentina,
States of America, Cuba and Argentina here. No time to introduce the individuals for the starter. Been pushed back in the programme just a little bit with the fault that developed earlier, but I can certainly do the honours in terms of introductions here. In lane one on that far side for Canada are Lindsay Jenerich from Victoria and Patricia O'Bee, also from Victoria. United States there in shot, that's Kristen Hedstrom and Julie Nichols. Combination from California and Boston. I'm enjoying the conditions here today. Because although it's not a sunny day, they don't like too much heat for the competitors. That fair water which they've got. The predictions earlier in the day were not too promising, but it's turned out okay. Third position at the moment in lane four are the Cubans, Yema Velasquez Falcon and Jocelyn Dominguez. But it's the Americans who are looking to dominate, 26-year-old Kristen Hedstrom from California, and Julie Nichols at 34 comes from a fantastic sporting family. Her mum played hockey and cricket, and she had an uncle who was an international athlete as well. States are the ones to catch. Central lane, they will come to 500 metres in a time of around 1.43.9 actually. Jenerich will be in second for Canada, Cuba 3, Canada 4, sorry, Korea 4, and Argentina then in the fifth. Hedstrom and Nichols. Top American combination. Already through to that final, by the way. Great that Sophie Hosking and Kat Copeland, who put in a terrific performance the other day. It's looking good for the United States of America at the moment in this lane three. There's too much to be having choice of lanes today. So pretty fair conditions across the lake and no particular crosswinds, which is what the competitors hate. Another overhead shot for you that shows the dominance that United States have at the moment in the race. Hope has probably gone for Argentina. Lane 5, Maria Clara Rona and Milka Kraljev struggling to keep pace, certainly with the American combination, which has a distinct advantage at the moment. The Canada's Lindsay Jenerich and Patricia Obie, those at the Oregon State University. Her partner Lindsay is human movement studies. Canada are just second. Cuba third with Yema Velasquez Falcon, a taekwondo expert. Discipline required for that sport as well as this one. The USA are still in one. Canada are still in two. It's looking like a North American double at the moment. There is a public address system informing the spectators on the towpath of what is happening, and of course those in the grandstand. Although there's a giant screen here that shows the race developing, it's nice for the information to be passed on to those spectators who don't really assess the situation of the race until they get to about 500 metres out from home. And that's where the Americans are headed right now. The greatest of the competitions, this Olympic rowing event for the Americans so far this week. But this one is looking better. Hedstrom and Nichols. Californian and the Bostonian. But a good combination, clearly. I think they can count on a place in the final. They're looking relatively easy for them at the moment. The stroke rate update for you, 34 for the Canadians and 35 for the Americans. All that matters really is that the Americans are coming to 1500 metres with the advantage, and a distinct advantage it is as well, at least a length and a half, I would think. Cuba now applying some pressure on Canada, however. Little in it between those two crews. Korea down in fourth and well back, and even further back in fifth for Argentina. Disappointment for Korea Republic if Myung-Chun Kim and Seo-Ji Kim from Bohan City don't make it through into the final, but it's not looking too good for them. It's looking very good for the United States of America and for Cuba and Canada. They are the three who are leading the way here, and the three of the team who will be rowing again in the final. Certainly United States of America being urged home every inch of the way across Dorney Lake now by the spectators under the leaden skies, but you might have thought the sun was shining for them. It's been an impressive performance from the United States. And, one of the better performances as well from the Stars and Stripes, put in by Christian Hedstrom and Julie Nichols. They come up to the second grandstand, knowing the finishing line is a welcome sight. Canada are still ahead of Cuba in the hunt for second. A hunt that would appear to be successful. There'll be plenty of cheering from Montreal and Toronto and Winnipeg and Victoria for that Canadian crew who are going to be second, but it's USA first. 7.13, Canada second, Cuba third. And they are the successful crews, unsuccessful in this particular race, Korea Republic and Argentina.
Thank you very much,
good effort then from Hedstrom and Nichols. And we're very pleased with that. Argentina coming home now. So three crews went through to the final, and they were this crew from the United States of America, Canada and Cuba. So very much a North American triumph here. At Lake Dorney in Eton.
Next on the water, it's the Repechage of the lightweight men.
Job well done. You can go away and relax for the rest of the day, girls, now. USA 1, 713.82. Canada 2nd in 715.37. Cuba 3rd, 719.37.